squads, yeah.
Yep. You think he also got first in dubs with Tode himself.
Nice.
One of the NPTs. Yeah, well, I mean, it was against ZD and Dexter.
Oh, yeah, no, that might be fair.
Yeah, but so you see the Charizard starting out here.
Yeah.
And Beast is a... Well, you kind of have to play aggressive. Oh, he got the sticky, though. But it transfers now.
It's like hot potato.
Yo, you're not dead. You're not dead. That was a sour spot. Fair. Thankfully. But... There we go. Yeah, we see...
This character gives me a headache.
Oh, the C4 fell off. Should be fine.
I didn't even know that was the ledge. That was so far away. The number of times that I have been hit by Cypher through, like, I felt like a weight lifted off me, seeing that you could just spike through that.
Yeah. Oh, the back throw.
Back throw back air is like deadly. If y'all don't know, on like middleweights, it will kill at 20% if you grab them right by the ledge on a when they're small blast zones.
There is the CEO set, Puppe and Simsora.
Oh yeah.
Great set. And the up tilt. Let's do it.
So, yeah, Waluigi obviously fighting back right here. I think that Ivysaur is definitely one of, like, it's definitely going to do, in theory, the best against Snake. But obviously, Beast is the Charizard guy, and it has been working so far.
Yeah, are you able to keep your distance a bit with Ivy, and you of course have an access to a projectile.
And you destroy him in disadvantage.
Yeah, it's the sour spot there. That hit him? Even Beast, like sour spot?
What are you doing? What? These are all these things that I did not know were Charizard things, but he's doing them so well.
Yeah, we see. Oh, going for spot dodge there. So only get hit by the F tilt. So armoring through. Yeah. The armor through. You run
catching
up
F tilt. Wow.
Sweet spot.
Waluigi obviously not out of this, though. I mean, we're at, you know, down throw into a up tilt, but not like the actual troop. Just you gotta get a little bit of a tech chase.
Yeah, we see. Yep, Flayable's coming out. Oh, not getting enough. Not doing it
not
soon
quite.
Enough. Back throw, back there. Yep. Sour spot though. Going high.
Yeah, Charizard's definitely a character that can punish you for doing for going high though.
Yeah, definitely. Because also that back air hits super high near the end of it.
Yeah.
It's insane how high that move hits.
Oh no. Oh
my
no!
God. That was even sweet spot. That was sour spot. But yeah, Charizard's very strong.
Yeah.
I think a lot of times the back throws that the ledges are putting Waluigi and damned if you do, damned if you don't situations.
Yeah, exactly.
Because you can recover low. We saw what happened last time. You got hit through the PS2 stage. It wasn't even the the lower end.
Yeah, and it's not Battlefield. Like that's a. Oh my gosh! And Waluigi played against. God, what's her name? Moxie now.
Moxie.
And one, I think.
Granted, Genesis was a long time ago. Yeah. At Genesis 6.
And played it pretty close the last time that they played here. But, but that was mostly Ivysaur. This is, you know, a whole different pocket monster.
Pocket monster, indeed. Really, speaking of pocket monster, running back to PS2.
Yeah.
Maybe his own field advantage. See, we didn't get one of those jokes out of the way.
Oh, no, there
you go. You had to get one of those jokes.
Yeah.
No.
For sure, it's in your contract. Oh,
that was a great. You could not do anything there.
Mm-hmm.
You were caught in a situation on that platform.
That's where you buy in on your conditioning. You know, like that's where you cash in.
Yeah. Even then, it's what do you like? Even if you're Beast, you kind of know you can do that.
Yeah.
Up to a kill, but as grenade throws it away right before. Even then, gonna just trade it to Cypher.
Oh, there you go.
Armoring through.
Free damage.
Beast has been very good at timing out his...
Yeah. Oh, there you go.
See, also...
Oh, Beast shaking his head, too. He knows that he went too high.
Flare Blitz loses to everything, too.
Mm-hmm.
Flare Blitz is not a good move. To landing up air. Landing up air is obnoxious. That...
Exactly.
Yeah.
You can... with that up, he is so scary if you're Snake.
Yeah. And we saw there just calling out... calling out Lugi's lack of...
landing options and just kind of...
Well, and his... And is just waiting. His waiting above stalling. Just having to stall. Oh, but no. Beast catching it and dropping the grenade. And Waluigi hitting it with his own back air.
So now that I think about it, actually. Oh my god.
This dude just ran up F smash.
Charizard is happy to just kind of sit there and trade with Snake.
Yes, because you die late.
Yeah, and it's not like that he's really going for all these combos that have to be frame tight or even strings, really.
He can back throw barrier.
Just, yeah, he can just kind of break you down. And
yeah, Ulugi going high and getting the gain C4 at 21%. See back though, switch. Nope, he's gonna stay right there. Yeah, making it back to the ledge. And he knew.
Yeah.
But that's not gonna kill. Hey, that looking at is a that is indeed a kill that kills, but it's not the kill through.
Exactly.
And we see switch. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's so much damage.
53%.
Oh, you got the late hit bear too. Oh.
Uh-huh. All right, let's see
if
we can do it.
Oh, he still got hit by the grenade.
Yeah.
I think the grenade actually pushed him in, like the throw animation pushed him into that.
Oh yeah, no, that's interesting.
What?
Oh wow, just so close by Walugi.
Yep, Walugi has it. There we go. Oh, something hit him. I think it may have been a missile. It may have been Nikita.
I'm just gonna say that was some like snake movement that I'm snake not cool movement. Enough to like understand. But whatever it was, it worked. So game two, we kind of saw Walugi kind of got to do what he wanted to do more. Like, obviously, he had a little bit more space to run around, it felt like, and so he got to abuse Charizard's lack of good approach options when it came down to it. And Beast was not getting those reads that he got in disadvantage against Walugi in game one that he did in game two.
Oh, that's not great. That's a raspberry.
Well, what's the... Oh, that's pineapple.
Yeah, why are you picking all mine?
I was just looking.
Created my rainbow here.
Anyways, congratulations.
So we're going back to PS2 for the third time.
Yeah.
Understandable. PS2 makes the best game. It's at a top tier level, it is the most neutral stage in the game.
Yeah.
I'm not going to deny that. I don't think it's the most neutral stage in the game. I think at a top character, top tier level it is, but that's a different conversation. The back here, once again, super strong. I don't think it's a jump.
It's also the biggest stage on the stage list if you're not playing with Kalos.
Yeah.
Think.
Well, I think even with Kalos, it's a bigger stage.
Yeah.
It's huge. It's a stage wise, it's so long.
Oh, wow. The hitbox extension made it so that there was enough lag for Walugi to come in and punish the F smash.
I think it's a great way on Walugi because knowing that there's a hitbox extension and you hit the green. There's
welcome
F tilt to be doing so much mileage for Beast there. It's because they kill. They're super strong. Yeah, and they're. Each time Beast has made an early Recibe back, Walugi's just not been able to get the C4 placement right.
You might as well just kind of leave that there and just, because then he has to walk up to you through the C4, through the fire and the flames.
Oh, yeah, it's so unfortunate. Oh, not going to get the follow-up, though. What if dash attack would have hit instead? And he, Beast keeps walking into these grenades.
Yeah.
And he keeps getting hit by them.
Oh, there you go.
Doing so much for Walugi. Once again, it's the up tilt.
You ever watch a Walugi set and think, what is the opponent supposed to do? Like, Charizard is too big to be contesting all of these grenades and all of this pressure that Walugi's creating just by existing.
Yeah, there's a problem with... Oh, yeah. The grenade is frame one! That's really dumb. Grenade should not be frame one, but...
Walugi is smart too, and so he's starting to get some of these reads that he was not getting in. He's starting to get the download on kind of what Beast has been wanted to do. Some of his approach options have been kind of linear, and Walugi is absolutely cashing in right now.
His grenades, even when he doesn't hit them, has Beast scared out of his damn mind.
Because
he's been getting hit by them each and every time.
C4's at his feet. He's going to blow it.
Going low. Yeah, it has to come back, but
and,
no, getting by. And there we go. Just
back air.
Yeah.
That move got buffed in this game.
Did it?
Oh!
Just do it.
And that is actually a home turf win for Walugi.
From DBA.
Protecting the city.
You see Walugi just doing a little pop off there.
Mm-hmm.
There's y'all. That is going to be it for us. Yeah, I know. Too many good sets tonight.
Yeah. Hey. Congratulations to Walugi. Very good set, and I hope to see him get higher on the PR. I always like watching his sets. Good stuff by Beast too.
There's always the bracket of alternate success.
Yeah, and it's been fun. Obviously, you know, check in at the VG Bootcamp stream to watch me and Nick every Tuesday and/or Friday.